may through the steadfast observance of Lent gain pardon for sins and newness of life after the likeness of your risen Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. So if, we began this as Wednesday, Lenten season calls for us the call to repentance or penance, okay? Like what I said, the mark of ashes reminds us of our mortality, okay? We are mortal beings, that one day we're born, one day we'll die, we'll go back to ashes, okay? So, but the important thing is, where did we come from, where we are now, and where we are going, okay? So that's why we are going back to God, and how are we going to, what we do, you know, reminds us of our death, and what's after death, okay? That's why we call us, like today I said, it's a good time for us to pray more, to fast, okay, and also for almsgiving. Good deeds that we do, that we can reward us at the end of life to be with God. It's a funny feeling for everyone because it's strange to be, I don't know how comfortable people were in receiving it through their head, that they disturbed them, or no matter how, what form they use, it's still acceptable to them. But again, yes, well, it does change a lot of things, you know. But I think the beautiful thing is, I hope that you come with that faith, as long as ashes are spread on them, remind them that the meaning of what is behind this, eh? Yes. And I hope everybody accepts that, yeah. One way or another. And I think what I think would a beautiful, very important question, this time of Lent calls us because of the distancing, and people are in their own corners because of the restriction and also fear of a lot of that. I think observance of Lent calls us to more deepening of our faith, renewal, okay? So I think that is a wonderful thing we can have also. Lent can open us that to be not to be fearful, but to fear not, you know, because God is with us. And that is, I think, beautiful thing that can remind us of that.